So it looks like Crucible is going back to the drawing board. Crucible says we're back with another developer update. We're taking Crucible into closed beta starting tomorrow. I had spoken extensively about Crucible both in my live streams as well as in my previous video that I did about Crucible, that most of the problem with Crucible revolved around the lack of competitiveness. If you really want a game in 2020 to be successful, it must be picked up by mainstream YouTubers as well as mainstream Twitch streamers, so that you end up getting more eyes on the game. As you can see, there aren't many people who are following this game. There's roughly 14,000 people, and this is a game, of course, released by Amazon Studios. It is by no means their first go around at trying to release a game, but it is a complete and total failure in taking into consideration the lack of competitiveness, which is what draws people to Twitch. If you actually take a look at Twitch and you look at most of the games that are actually really popular, you know, if we take a look over here at the browse section, you'll see most of what is popular on Twitch revolves around competitiveness, whether it's games like League of Legends, Fortnite, Counter-Strike, Valorant, Dota 2, Warzone, literally like how many games on here where the player experience revolves heavily around the PvP competitiveness. And that was one of the biggest things that Crucible lacked. It lacked that high-paced competitive spirit behind it. And that's one of the reasons why it failed. Did it have core things like, for example, no voice chat or no text chat? Yes, but those are things that are easily resolved, especially in 2020 with something as simple as Discord, which most people by now have access to. It's not like back in my day when I was a teenager where we didn't have free voice chat. We had to pay for things like Ventrilo or TeamSpeak. Nowadays, those things are easily resolved with a free download. And so the real thing of why Crucible unfortunately died was because it just lacked that real competitive edge that people are looking for. Yes, there were classes that did a lot of things that were different. It did things that were somewhat enjoyable. But for me, primarily, the main problem of the game is it lacked that PvP interaction. In most other MOBA games, you'll see they'll have creep waves. And typically, the purpose of those creep waves are to draw the player versus player interaction, or so that another player could come in and secure a gank, because taking out an opponent had an effect on the game. Not really so much in Crucible, because you share an experience pool. So it's not like you can kind of out-level one particular opponent that you're fighting, because there are no lanes. And of course, a lot of the game where you can kind of bypass fighting other opponents, because the map is so big, it doesn't really draw you in to that player versus player interaction. Some people don't even pay attention to the ping system that they introduced. And the other thing, of course, that there is no ranking system within the game. So effectively, most of the people that you're playing against are pugs, and no one really cares about pug stomping. It doesn't really show the high-end skill of the individual player that you'll see in, for example, on things like Fortnite or in Valorant, where you'll see the really skilled player and you'll see their skill come to the fore. And that's one of the biggest things, in my opinion, that was missing in Crucible. The lack of real PvP, like drawing the individuals towards actually competing for certain points. It's good to be able to walk around and someone, for example, can have like a creep destroying build, which you can do within the game. You can make some characters are a little bit easier to kill, kind of the little minions that are on the map, and some are geared a little bit more towards a player versus player interaction. But there isn't enough movement, there isn't enough PvP interaction within the game to draw out, you know, team fights are something that very rarely happens in Crucible. Yes, in a game where you take skilled players and you can put them and compete them against one another, sure, you'll see that. But for the most part, in the overall experience of the game, you don't. And that's one of the reasons why it failed so hard. Aesthetically, of course, it is well pleasing to look at, but unfortunately, aesthetics alone will not, you know, reward you with a player base. What people are really looking for is they're looking for a solid interaction where they can showcase their skills. That's why PvP games have been so popular, especially on streaming platforms like Twitch and on YouTube, because people are looking to showcase how good they are at a particular game so that other people will watch their content. And that's one of the areas where Crucible fails, and that's where it needs to focus on having competitive PvP, drawing individuals towards certain points and certain interactions within the game, so that people will be it basically end up fighting each other. That's something that's sorely lacking within the game. Between that and, of course, a competitive ranked, you're not going to draw the competitive player without having a competitive ranking system within the game. And those are the two things that I think that Crucible should really, really focus on, is that PvP, that hardcore PvP interaction.